No, that's it. Thanks.
Ms. Craven, did you?
Yeah, we're talking here as if all this traffic came from that housing development or all of those housing developments in this project called Springville. And that's not the case. The vast majority of this traffic is traffic that didn't exist but before Springville Interchange came in. And I think that our model didn't show anywhere near as much traffic. A lot of that traffic's coming from Lewis Road, coming from Simi, coming from Moore Park, people who are going to Oxnard, maybe the military base, and they're coming down Las Poses, turning onto and going on. So this developer isn't responsible for that traffic. This developer is responsible for putting in the signals based on warrants, and the projection was that he needed to do it because he was putting in a housing development. But he didn't. I would maintain that if we had connected Earl Joseph and remember, before all this started, there was a fence there, and you couldn't even go down Earl Joseph. If you came out of that housing tract and wanted to go down Earl Joseph, you had to make a U-turn and come back to Ponderosa, turn left, and go down. So all of this traffic, once we opened up Earl Joseph so that Ponderosa could come through, it did exactly what it was supposed to do, which was relieve traffic from the Las Poses interchange, which was a D or an F. I think it was at an F level.
It was an F.
It was an F level, but it has taken all that traffic and put it over there, and I don't think we realized how much additional traffic would be coming from Eastern Camarillo and from the Somas area from 118, and so. You know, I believe that the conditions were put on the developer as they would be on any normal developer, to when at the 80% level, and the developer is moving forward and doing it earlier, and I think that's about all we can expect.
Okay, this is informational only. We do have a study session to get into. Also, now we